that we have more effective talent management policies. That means for me that we can enable employees and engage employees to deliver upon strategic objectives of the organization.
In 5 years, I would say that most of the decisions in HR, most of the choices, most of the interventions are driven by analytics and not driven by assumptions, not driven by myths, not driven by mental models that are no longer a problem. So I think in 5 years' time, I'm super positive where it will be.
I almost get the impression that we won't be talking about analytics so much because it will be a core component of each of the programs that we deliver. I'd like to think that everyone within HR, or at least the wide majority of HR, will be comfortable talking about data and insights and how it drives business performance and employee experience. It is vital to the future of the HR function. And if we don't do it and do it well, then another part of the business will. And I suspect they will have more interest in business outcomes than they will in employee well-being and experience. So I think it's important for HR to grasp this opportunity.
I think we'll be much more related to the complexity of organizations and organizational structure. So we already got a request from an organization where 30% of the workforce is outsourced, but they have no understanding of what's going on there. And they feel that as a risk because that's an outsourced workforce and a lot of stuff is going on there, but they have no understanding of what's going on there. So, and they asked us to start thinking about how can we create data to add that to our regular employee workforce to connect those two and to understand what's going on. And maybe also in this particular case, what kind of risks are we having with that outsourced workforce?